大家好，欢迎来到 W 档案。如果一个杀人犯在法庭上不是道歉，而是一笑置之，表现出一副无所谓的样子，你会有什么感觉？这样的事情正在真实上演。2016年发生在美国密歇根州的一起案件中，凶手以最残忍的方式杀害了一名高中生。在法庭上，这名高中生家人选择了原谅，他们只是希望凶手能表现出一些悔恨之意。但是凶手并没有任何悔意，而是一脸的不屑，甚至还嘲笑受害者的家人，好像他什么也没有做错一样。这到底是什么样一起案件？凶手为何会如此嚣张？案件的结局如何？下面让我们一起开始今天的案件，嚣张的杀人犯。这起案件中的受害人名叫乔丹·克里，1998年7月出生在美国密歇根州。他的父亲叫肖恩·布里斯托尔，母亲叫凯伦·克里。很不幸的是，他的父亲在他出生5个月后就去世了，所以他没有机会见到自己的父亲。尽管失去了父亲，但是克里的童年很幸福，因为他的妈妈尽一切努力照顾他，让他健康成长。克里也没有让妈妈失望，他从小到大都很优秀，他也是妈妈的骄傲。克里是一个很酷、外向和真诚的人，他喜欢玩各种游戏。克里是那种每个人都喜欢和他一起玩的人，他基本上和每个人都是朋友，和他在一起从不无聊。克里在密歇根州的阿什托诺县长大，他在斯洛斯中学上学，后来去了先锋高中。在高中期间，克里学习成绩优异，一直名列前茅。另外，他还是一名优秀的运动员，参加了学校的橄榄球队。他从不缺席休赛期的训练或团队活动。由于克里在球队的优异表现，他经常获得优秀运动员奖。克里还非常善于做手工，他经常用回形针和橡皮筋做一些小东西。克里的理想是希望有朝一日成为一名工程师。2016年是克里人生中最重要的一年，因为这一年他刚满18岁，即将成为成年人。这一年也是他高中的最后一年，他期待着毕业和参加毕业舞会。克里明年将以橄榄球运动员的身份升入密歇根大学，这让他非常兴奋。生活对于克里来说非常的美好和充满希望，然而这一切美好都被一场突如其来的袭击终止了。2016年10月4日，这天是个星期二，一名建筑工地的维修工人听到了几声枪响，他立即跑过去查看，发现克里躺在大楼外的一条小路上，身上中了一枪。警方很快赶到了现场，发现克里已经死亡，并立即对此案展开调查。调查只用了几天时间，就有3名非裔青年因涉嫌犯罪被捕。他们分别是17岁的丹特·赖特、18岁的德拉诺·克雷格和19岁的杰里·莫斯·埃里森。他们被指控在抢劫时杀害了克里。这3个人都是附近社区的帮派分子，整天无所事事。当天克里放学后正走在回家的路上，在路上遇到了这3个非裔青年。他们喜欢克里身上的运动服和球鞋，于是对克里实施了抢劫。在抢劫的过程中，丹特向克里开了一枪。在克里中枪倒地后，他们拿走了克里的财物、运动服和球鞋。3人迅速逃离了现场。由于18岁的克雷格和19岁的埃里森已经到了美国刑法成年的法定年龄，被分别指控犯有非法持枪、共谋抢劫和2级谋杀罪。但是17岁的丹特还是未成年人。检察官和丹特在审判之前达成了认罪协议，这样可以减轻对他的惩罚。我们今天重点讲讲丹特，尤其是他在犯罪后在法庭上的表现，看看他是如何自己作死的。17岁的丹特也是一名高三的学生，即将毕业，但他并不是一个好学生，整天和一群小混混待在一起，偷鸡摸狗，游手好闲，除了好事什么事都干。丹特被逮捕后很快就承认了是他开枪杀害了克里。按照美国的司法程序，每起案件正式开庭前都有一个审前听证会。审前听证会就像一个小型预审判，辩方和检方都向法官陈述案情和证据，然后法官决定是否有足够的证据起诉被告。审前听证会之后就是正式的开庭审理。在美国司法程序中，以陪审团审判为主，嫌犯将由陪审团决定他们到底是否有罪。但是如果嫌犯在陪审团审判之前就主动向检察官坦白并承认自己有罪的话，可以得到较轻的量刑或者缓刑处罚。 另外，审前听证会也是嫌犯表现忏悔的最佳时机，只要表现出认罪悔过之意，一般都会被法官采纳。17岁的丹特就是因为未成年条款和负责此案的检察官达成了认罪协议，丹特承认是自己开枪杀害了克里，这样他很可能获得很轻的惩罚。不过这个减轻惩罚的机会都被丹特自己在听证会上的作死表现给取消了。在听证会上，丹特承认是自己枪杀了克里。
On the morning of October 4th, 2016, did you agree and conspire with two other individuals, Delvino Gracie and Jamarius Ellison, to commit an armed robbery?
Yeah.
And who are you going to rob?
Jordan Cleek.
Jordan Cleek. And that afternoon, did you in fact rob Jordan Cleek?
Yeah.
And did you use a gun to place him in fear in order to take his property?
Yeah.
And as a result of that armed robbery, what did you do with that gun and Mr. Jordan Cleek?
Shot him.
And where did you shoot him?
On the top, by his head.
And did you kill him with that shot?
Yes.
丹特回答问题的声音如此平静，给人的感觉他在谈论一些平常的事情，比如他早餐吃了什么，而不是他如何冷血地杀死了一个人。克里的母亲坐在离杀害他儿子凶手几米远的地方，一直无法抑制自己的泪水。接着，克里的母亲凯伦在听证会上发言，由于他悲痛欲绝，几乎说不出话来，因此他的表妹代替他宣读声明。
Your Honor, my name is Courtney Clay, and I'm Karen's cousin. She's asked me to read this on her behalf.
Sure.
Jordan Michael Clay, born July 26, 1998. Murdered October 4, 2016, at 18 years old. Jordan has no future. Jordan can no longer choose to go to college.Jordan can no longer choose to change. Jordan can no longer make a difference. Jordan can no longer fall in love or have a family. Jordan no longer has a future. I've lost my only child, my son, my baby, my friend. More than that, I've lost laughter and love. I no longer have the hope of having grandchildren. I've lost the enjoyment of holidays and birthdays and of everyday life.As a mother or any parent ages, her children are there to care for her. But now in my life, I walk this journey alone. I no longer have that luxury because that was carelessly and cruelly taken from me. I no longer get to see the smile of my son when he walks through the door and brings me a Frosty from Wendy's at the end of his shift. The simple pride of a hard work shift and bringing his mom something that just makes her happy. Songs we used to enjoy,I can no longer listen to. Movie nights we did together no longer exist. I could continue with all the loss. I won't. This year was supposed to be a year of celebration, of senior pictures with prom and graduation and parties. Instead, it was a nightmare that no parent should ever endure. On the nights I managed to sleep, I wake up hearing my son scream for me, to then have to realize all over again, night after night, my son is dead, gone.Taken. For what? Why? Can you answer the question? Why? Why? I have an answer. Your answer will never be good enough. There will never be an answer good enough to satisfy why you shot my son. Why you thought that what you had should be yours. Why you felt that what you wanted, you were entitled to. Why you thought his death was an acceptable response to your jealousy or desire to what he had.Drugs, clothes, money, jewelry, phones, shoes, whatever it was that you felt you needed more than his life. Your why will never be better than his life. Your want will never trump my son's death. You get to live. Get to wake up every day. Your life continues. I sincerely hope that whatever it was you wanted so badly that you felt the need to murder my son was worth the next at least 52 years of your continued existence.You won't get the luxury of raising your child because you took mine away. So because for the first time in my life, I feel hate in my heart, here is what I hope. I hope that every time you want for a jacket, that you stay cold. I hope that every time you want for shoes, you get a hole in yours. I hope that every time you want for a meal, you go hungry. And hope that every time you want for a bed, you have a sleepless night. I hope that every time you wish for your mother, she doesn't come for a visit. But more than anything, because we, and I, am nothing like you, I don't wish or hope any of that upon you. I simply wish that you go to prison for the maximum time your plea agreement allows, that you become something more than what you were taught to be in your miserable life, and that your child gets brought up far away from the life you led, because it's obvious to me and everyone here that you need help. Your actions have led you to a prison cell, but have also created an empty cell that I live in every day. While you can still hope to be released one day, I'll never escape my hell. You are still alive, but Jordan has no future. Thank you, Your Honor. We're done.
当凯伦发言时，丹特坐在那里不停地微笑，表现得好像他所做的没什么大不了的。此后，法官让丹特和他的律师开始发言。丹特在他的律师发言后，在法庭上说出了下面这段非常混蛋的话。
I just want to tell y'all, I'll be home soon. R.I.P. Keon, I love my family.
That's all you got to say.
他夺走了别人的生命，还胆敢在法庭上嘲笑受害人家人的痛苦。这种在受害人家人伤口上撒盐的行为，比杀人行为本身更加邪恶。在古代，如果犯人敢嘲笑公堂，首先要打十八大板。虽然这样的做法已经不合时宜了，但是嘲笑法庭必将付出代价。法官被丹特冷漠的态度彻底激怒了。
You know, I have never in 23 years approximately ever not accepted a sentence agreement between the parties because it's bargained for sentence by the parties. But watching you sit there, smile and laugh and shake your head like this was no big deal, I'm very tempted to just say I'm not going to accept this sentence agreement. We'll go to trial, and if you're convicted of felony murder, you'll go to prison for the rest of your life. That means you'll die there. That's what I'm tempted to do. Mr. Bella, do you want me to accept this sentence agreement?
Your Honor, may we approach prison?
Yes.
当听到法官取消了他的认罪协议，而正式开庭审理此案时，丹特脸上的笑容消失了，整个人瞬间懵了，试图让他的律师说些什么，但他的律师无奈摇摇头走开。丹特急忙补救，表示歉意，希望法官能原谅他的幼稚行为，显然已经晚了。法官和检察官商议后，撤销了丹特的认罪协议，将开庭正式审理此案。丹特的辩护律师代表他道歉，说这个青年遭受了某种情绪问题。有些人微笑，表示恐惧。丹特的母亲也为自己的儿子辩护，说他是无辜的，他有一些精神疾病，应该在法庭上被考虑。他还说，他的儿子在生活中就总是微笑面对一切。这样强词夺理的说法，真的让人大跌眼镜。除非能在医学上证明丹特是傻子，否则正常人都能控制自己的表情。虽然丹特的认罪协议被取消了，但是克里的家人还是尝试着原谅他的所有行为。克里的家人希望这一切能尽快结束，这样他们就可以重新继续他们的生活。最后，丹特因二级谋杀罪和持枪抢劫罪被判处50年监禁，25年后才有可能获准假释。当丹特从监狱出来时，他至少已经42岁了。按照丹特的罪行，陪审团本可以判处他终身监禁，那样他就要在监狱里待一辈子了。但陪审团并没有顶格惩罚这个邪恶的青年，考虑到他是未成年人以及克里家人的原谅，还是减轻了对他的惩罚。在法庭上，如果丹特没有那样邪恶的微笑，并且说出那样混蛋的话，也许对他的惩罚会更轻。丹特的两名同伙克雷格和埃里森被判处40年监禁，15年后才有可能获准假释。克里是个聪明和勤奋的人，前途一片光明，他的生命不应该这样被夺走，希望他在天堂可以安息。凯伦彻底失去了他的儿子，他再也没有机会和他说话，甚至还被凶手嘲笑。即使这样，他还是选择原谅丹特，希望他能在监狱里改过自新。丹特夺走了别人的生命，还表现出无所谓的样子，真的让人很气愤，真希望判处他终身监禁，让他在监狱中一直反省。 今天的视频就到这里。你觉得法官的做法对吗？丹特应该被判处终身监禁吗？请在评论区告诉我你的想法。感谢收看，我们下期视频见。